Hi there, today I'm going to be teaching you how to properly clean and put away your saxophone. And in order to do so, you need to know the parts of your instrument. We have the reed, the mouthpiece, the neck of the instrument, where most of your spit buildup will be, and the body. So now that we have the instrument, you need to know three things: what to use, where to clean it, and how to clean it. Step 1. You're going to need some sort of multi-purpose surface cleaner, something that's good with glass. You're also going to need a towel that's also good with glass and goes good with the multi-surface cleaner. Your saxophone should come with some sort of towel, something like this, some soft fabric. And lastly, you're going to need Q-tips. Lots of them. Step 2. Where to clean it. Like I said before, most of the spit buildup will be right here, but it'll also be right here at the bottom of the instrument. When focusing on cleaning the body of the instrument, we need to focus right here on the keys. Step 3. How to clean your saxophone. Well, ideally, when you're ready to clean your instrument, that's because you're done playing. So let's take the instrument apart first. The first step you're going to want to take is loosening these screws right here at the top of the body, removing the neck from the body. When you've done that, you want to place the body like this, keys up, so that way you do not damage the keys. Then you want to proceed by removing the mouthpiece of the instrument from the neck by doing a twisting motion to your left. After that, you're going to want to place that there, and then you're going to want to, twist these screws, loosening the mouthpiece from the reed. You're going to want to take the reed and place it within the guard, so that way you do not damage this reed. So now that we have the instrument taken apart, we want to start the actual cleaning process. And in order to do so, we want to first start off by taking that yellow fabric soft cloth and taking the mouthpiece and wiping the end of it. And after that, you're going to want to take your mouthpiece guard and put it in there. You're going to want to set that aside because later we're going to put that in our case. After that, you want to take the neck and go like that, try to get all the spit out. I know it's a little gross, but some spit will fall out. Not all of it will though, so you're going to want to take that yellow fabric cloth again and get it as skinny as possible and just feed it through the neck of the instrument. Now that we're done cleaning the neck, you're going to want to put it aside as well as the towel. Now we get to the body. The body is a little bit more complicated. I also forgot to mention in the beginning of the video that you're going to need a little bit of water. Just a capful, just so that way you can dip your Q-tips into it. We're going to want to fill up a little cap of water, put that to the side. Okay, and once we've done that, we want to start the actual cleaning process of the body. So now that we're about to start cleaning the body, you're going to want to take a Q-tip, and you're going to want to dip it in the water that we have. As you can see, spit starts to build up within the instrument if you don't start to clean it. So what you're going to want to do, take that Q-tip and sort of wipe it down like that on every single key you have. So let's do that. After you've done so, you want to take that blue towel and spray the fabric cleaner on it. You're then going to want to take your instrument, the body of your instrument, and wipe it down as such as so, trying to get all the fingerprints and all the dirty marks off of your instrument. Clean the bell as well, don't forget that. And now that your instrument is nice and clean, you're gonna wanna put it back in the case. So let's do that. So when putting away your instrument, you need to be very careful and put everything exactly where it goes, so that way you don't damage the instrument, like always. So you're gonna wanna take the cap that goes to your body and put it in there. You're gonna wanna tighten these screws so that way this part of the instrument doesn't bend. And then after that, you're gonna wanna put the body where it goes inside the case. Then your mouthpiece with its guard on it, you're gonna wanna put that where it goes, and just basically put everything where it goes. You don't want anything on top of the body or anything that shouldn't be in the case, because that will go around in the case while you're moving and it will break some keys. After that, you just want to close your case, and that is how you clean your saxophone.